IRA launches second insurance week. Headline inflation eases to 9.2%. NCBA Tanzania plans expansion into key sectors. African Union approves African Continental Free Trade Area draft protocols. And beer and wine sales in Canada fall to all-time low. So it is another new month, and already it's the third month into 2023. The question is, just how realistic are the goals that you set at the start of this year? Are you living up to them? Are you keeping them positive? And are you changing some things about your business to make sure that you score positive on the things that you wanted through this 2023? My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. From wherever you're watching, we're glad you could make time. We have a lot lined up for you, but this is what you can expect on the show tonight.
COVID had a major impact. But of course, we know that on a daily basis, there are a couple of risks that we interface with, that we interact with, such as on the road, in our homes, in the public. You do not know when a tree is going to fall on someone. You do not know when one will fall sick. And so some of these challenges are the reasons why an ordinary Ugandan out there needs insurance.
Once again, welcome to the show. And this week we'll start with how to save money through insurance. Now, if you asked three people, or five, let's say, most of them would tell you insurance is for cars, health, fire, burglary, but no one would ever tell you that you can actually save through insurance. Now, that is a conversation that we want to have this week ahead of the second annual insurance week that will be happening. For just 50,000 shillings, you could actually start saving. And that is a conversation that we are holding with the PR and Market Development Manager of Uganda Insurers Association, Ibrahim Kalule, who will tell us how important this is, but also just how vital it is for you to attend the second annual insurance week, because all your questions about whether insurance is for the corporate or for everyone will be answered. That and more in Views from the Top this week. All right, Ibra, thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. Let's first talk about quick introduction, and then talk to us a bit about how UIA is getting involved in the insurance week.
Thank you very much. We have just concluded the launch of the insurance week here at the insurance tower in Kampala. My name is Kalule Ibrahim Gava, and I'm the public relations officer at the Uganda Insurance Association. The Insurance Week is purely about insurance. And the insurance players that are involved in the market, which are about 34 in the space of non-life, life, and microinsurance, get closer to the different Ugandans out there. So certainly, as the association, we are premised, or our foundation is premised on the, our mandate is premised on the essence of ensuring that the public out there is aware of insurance, so that once they're aware of insurance, they can be able to protect their future. And certainly, we can appreciate, like we earlier mentioned, that COVID had a major impact. But of course, we know that on a daily basis, there are a couple of risks that we interface with, that we interact with, such as on the road, in our homes, in the public. You do not know when a tree is going to fall on someone. You do not know when one will fall sick. And so some of these challenges are the reasons why an ordinary Ugandan out there needs insurance. So this week is going to be a platform where we get closer to our customers, not because as players in the insurance sector we've not been close, but this week is going to bring us all in a one-stop center where we ably interact with the public and share ideas on some of the challenges that the public has picked in insurance.
All right, so this is going to be the third time the UIA is participating in the week.
Yes.
What has been your take home from the last two participations, and what should we expect from your side this time around?
Certainly, as things start, for every campaign that will start, the momentum does not build on one set. So you would appreciate that with every process that takes on the first, the second, and the third, we are able to grow in terms of members that participate in the event, but also we are able to grow in terms of what solutions we provide. We will appreciate that the week will be crowning off with the awards, the Innovation Awards, and these are ideas that year in, year out, different insurance players who are members provide a central role in terms of innovation of solutions or products that can be sold. Today, you can appreciate that through bank assurance, one can enter their bank and be able to pick an insurance product. And of course, now even the products have evolved, that now soon they will be rolling out. There's a member that has already rooted rolling out of a product that will cost you about, I think, in the range of 600 to 700,000, which is a medical cover. So participation over the years also means that every year we are innovating through solutions that we can provide. Also, soon enough, there will be other players that are joining the market in terms of microinsurance, and these are looking out for an ordinary Ugandan who can be able to buy a policy that is as low as 16,000 shillings. So every year comes in new players in the market, but also comes different solutions that the market can be able to take on.
Okay, so for most people, insurance is more to do with cars and then health. But we know for a fact that there could be a way of saving through insurance, even for fees for your children. Maybe just talk to us about that and why more Ugandans should look into that direction.
Thank you very much. In terms of life insurance, this has been really adopted by many Ugandans out there. The numbers are growing over the years, and so it's a fast growing space in the insurance space. Specifically, when people think of insurance, sometimes they think about cars, they think about maybe their homes, they think about fire. But in the life section, insurance is looking out for an ordinary Ugandan that wants to save for a reason. So insurance can be used as a saving solution. If one wants, for example, to take children back to school, if one wants to educate their children for the university in the next 15 years, insurance is not necessarily short term per se, it's a long term. So what kind of objectives are you looking out there as an individual to save for your long term? You want to buy a plot of land which costs 100 million. You want to invest in a house. You want to save for your retirement. You want to save for your old age. So these are solutions that are long term. You're doing 15 years, you're doing 20 years. So there are products that you can save as low as 100,000, as low as 50,000 shillings on a monthly basis, so that in the next 15 years, you're able to reap off your investment. So I encourage the public out there to go out and seek from an insurance company what sort of solutions you can be able to take on for a long term, so that in the long run, you're able to benefit.
You're talking as low as 50,000. Does this finally then address the fact that finally the insurance sector is looking at the ordinary Ugandan? Because we know for a fact that most people will tell you that insurance is for the corporate class.
Certainly, there has been that feeling that insurance is for the rich, insurance is for the corporate class. But I must say, problems know no one. Problems do not know a rich person, do not know a poor person, do not know when risks are going to occur. And the most evident has been the recent pandemics that have occurred here in the country. Like I mentioned COVID, I mentioned Ebola. But also every day in, day out, people are falling sick in homes, and fires are gutting places. And of course, in the agriculture space, you see that we're also solutioning for that market, because there are evident risks in the agriculture space to do with climate, to do with pests. And all these are solutions that insurance is coming through to make sure that they support an ordinary Ugandan. So it's not necessarily for the rich. It's really how risk averse an individual is and how well an individual wants to manage their risk. So if someone out there wants to manage their risk, because we keep giving an example, every one of us wants to stay alive, but we are sure that at one day we'll probably pass on. But what kind of cushioning are you remedying? Are you living for your family? What saving solutions? Because insurance then gives you a saving solution, but also gives you a risk management solution. In the event that you have a challenge, you've passed on, you have a certain buffer that can be passed on to your family as savings, and also support you in, for example, your funeral, your last funeral rights. Mm. So there are a couple of other solutions which other players in the market may not be able to offer.
All right, so finally, what does UIA think through 2023 in regards to making more Ugandans aware about insurance and uptaking insurance?
The mandate of the association is to promote awareness. And so all our budgets are geared towards creating awareness. And of course, this particular year, it's more focused, depending on the, it's more focused with the institutions that we're going to be working with to reach out to the public. It's going to be a business-to-business approach where we are trying to interact with institutions like Enterprise Uganda, Uganda Investments Authority, to get closer, Uganda Manufacturers Association, to Kasita. We are trying to get closer to solution for different markets. Because over the years, we've been doing general awareness. We've been going to TVs, we've been going to radio to inform people. And right now, we believe that people know or have an idea about insurance. But our focus 2023 is more pivoted to institutions, is more pivoted to individuals, where we can solution for, like I mentioned, the manufacturers, the Kasitas, oil and gas, and farmers, to make sure that the solutions we are providing for them are those that serve their particular market.
Thank you very much, Ibrahim. Well, amazing conversation coming through there from Ibra. And look, it's something that you need to pay attention to, because if within 10 to 15 years you could have money for your children's fees, then it's probably something that is better than waiting to go to the bank. So apply too much pressure to get that money to have the kids go to school. So listen through, make some time and go down there and learn how to save through insurance. And of course, there are many different things that you need to understand as well. So if you have those questions, move down there and ask all of them about insurance. They'll be answered. It is for your own safety. Look, there's agriculture insurance. Equally, that is important for you that is looking to grow your money. But even for your business, in the recent past, we've seen fires destroying businesses. So why not take up a cover just to make sure in the event of any uncertainties, you are good to go. Remember, I keep saying business is about risk taking, but some risks can actually be averted. My name is Simon. You're watching The Business Show. Let's take a quick break now. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. Tell us where you're watching from. And probably the most interesting part of the show, there's all this feedback about how to make money, because it's that segment where you actually learn how you can make money. I'll see you after the break.